Actually, I forgot to introduce myself here. Okay, so myself Umkar Sawan. I am from Mumbai. I am not from Mumbai. My native is from Goa, but I just recently moved in Mumbai for a purpose of money. And yes, so shall we start? Let's begin. So what is the actual gear? So gear has simple definition. Okay, so first we have to when you have to transfer one energy, one power, one shaft to another shaft, then we use a gear. Okay, so this is a simple definition of gear. So there are two types. The first one is driven and driver. Okay, so with the help of driver is nothing but driver gears directly connected to the motor. So with the help of motor, driver rotates, and with the help of driver gear, driven gear also rotates. Okay, so this is the simple procedure of gear. Okay, so suppose this is my one driver gear and these are all the driven gear. So this gear is directly connected to the one motor. Okay, so this is a motor. So with the help of motor, driven gear also rotate. So what is the actual type of gear? Okay, so let's see what is the type of gear. Okay, there are many types of gear, but it classified according to the position of axis. Okay, suppose in parallel axis spur gear, helical gear, then rack and pinion. Okay, the intersecting are bevel gear, non-intersecting worm and arm gears. So let's see what is the most important gear used in industry. So let's go to Google and let's see what is the. So let's ask the Google what is the most important gear used in industry. Okay. Okay, did you see this song? This
nit nit tere utte nindra udaiyan mera to kuch tare din ge gawaiyan nit nit tere utte daulat lutai.
Proceed. So just type to Google use Bosch use gear in industry. So look at here, spur gear, helical gear, bevel gear. So these are the most three important gear used in industry. Okay, for in mechanism, for in the machines. Okay, so let's. What is the actual spur gear, helical gear, and the bevel gear? Okay, so first one is spur gear. So spur gear is a simple gear. So spur gear has. So just see here this diagram. So this is our spur gear. Okay, so first point is teeth is parallel to the axis of rotation. Means look at here. So if you see this teeth is just straight here, okay, and the parallel of axis means, so parallel to axis means this is your axis. So axis is parallel to the this teeth. So this is known as spur gear. Okay, so transmit the power one shaft to another shaft with the parallel shafts. Means okay, so this is our one axis and this is our second axis. So this axis also the parallel with each other. This is the property of spur gear. Okay, so it is used in electric screwdriver, washing machines and clothes and dryer, and it's very cheap. Okay, so if you buy any if you want to buy one gear, spur gear, so if you just go to any shop and then you can ask for spur gear, this is very cheap. Okay, so next one is helical gear. So what is helical gear? So helical gear is a some kind of spur gear, but it has one helix angle. Okay, and helix angle means suppose if you draw one axis, okay, this axis and these are the teeth. Okay, so in this gear teeth has some helix angle, so suppose 40 to 15 degree or else. Okay, and because of this angle helical gear operates smoothly. Okay, so this is a very advantage of helical gear. So if you give some angle to the teeth, then it operates smoothly. It has similar axis of rotation like spur gear. Suppose if you draw two axes, so these are the parallel axis. So this is the parallel axis to each other. So helical gear and if you differentiate the helical gear and spur gear, so only one difference, which is helical gear has some amount of angle and spur gear has no angle. It is just parallel to the rotation of axis. Okay, this is a simple difference between helical gear and spur gear. Next is bevel gear. So bevel gear has two types. First one is simple bevel gear and second one is spiral bevel gear. Okay, so in bevel gear, look at the position of axis. Okay, so these are the position of axis. So bevel gear used to be transmit the power into one shaft to another shaft, but shaft position is the perpendicular to the each other. Look at here, this is one position, this is one axis, and this is one axis. So this is a perpendicular. So in the bevel gear, shaft are perpendicular to each other. Okay, so so this is a simple bevel gear. Okay, and these two are the spiral bevel gears. So spiral bevel gear has some amount of just curve, okay, some amount of angle here. And in suppose if you look at your simple bevel gear, so it has no angle, it has only scales. Okay, so this is our back part and this is our front part. So front part has some amount of scales in bevel gear. So this is the difference between spiral bevel gear and simple bevel gear. Okay, so these are the main three gears used in industry. So we will learn how to draw these three gears with the help of proper calculations and proper parameters. Okay, so there are many types, like rack and pinion, herringbone, and worm and worm gear. So there are many types, but these are the simple. Okay, so rack and pinion has some, this is spur gear and this is a rack. So this is just we have to draw the spur gear. Then here in herringbone gear, these are the two helical gear. When two helical gear are just match with each other, then herringbone gear produce. So this is actually herringbone gear. So when we learn helical gear, then herringbone is nothing. Okay, so if you want the more information about the gear, just Google it. So in Google there are many informations. So you have to just Google it, you got many information there. So don't worry about that. Okay, so next one is gear tooth terminology. So what is the gear tooth terminology? Okay, so if you Google it, gear tooth terminology, then you got like something around 20 to 25 terms in gear tooth terminology. But we just forgot all these things. We will focus on these four things only. Okay, the first one is outer circle, then pitch circles, then base circle, and then root circle. So we see simple terms. So outer circle means, so top of the gear, if we draw one circle of the top of the gear, then we get outer circle, okay, which is also known as addendum circle, which is RO. Okay, if you draw a circle on base of this gear, below of the gear, then we get root circle, which is also known as dedendum, which is RR. Okay, so these are the simple terms which I don't think I have to explain to you. Okay, so these are some simple terms. Okay, then pitch circles and base circles. Okay, these are the very important terms when we learn a gear to terminology. So I just explain these pitch circles and base circles in next slide. Okay, so look at this diagram. What is the pitch circles? So look at here, judge. So if we so this is one teeth and this is another teeth. Okay, so these are the two gears. So this is first gear and this is second gear. So if we made these two gears, okay, and then there is one point. Okay, so if you made two gears, there we got one point there. Suppose this one. This is our first point. Okay, this is our second point. If you just rotate this gear, then we got point like this. Okay, so this point is known as pitch point. Okay, and if you draw a circle intersecting to this point, then we got us one circle which is known as pitch circle. Okay, so this is a simple definition of pitch circle. Just understand these things. There are nothing much into the pitch circles and base circles. Okay, just understand this. Next. So actually this is not a proper gear design, proper gear lecture. Okay, so if you want more information, you just Google it. So there we got more information about the gear. I just explained the basic things about the gear. Okay, and I just explained terms which we require in designing of gear. So that's the thing. Okay, next thing. So in the gear design, there are many terms. Okay, the first one is module. So what is module? So just remember that module is nothing but, okay, so module is nothing but D upon Z. Okay, so D is nothing but pitch circle diameter, pitch circle, this is RP, okay. So diameter of pitch circle. Okay, this is a pitch circle radius when you use, and this is Z means number of teeth. Okay, so just remember this formula. Then pressure angle. So pressure angle, actually this is very complicated terms. So just remember that pressure angle is in between 14 degree to 22 degree. Okay, so if you want more information about the pressure angle, just Google it. There are many terms. Okay, then RP. So pitch circle radius, we recently just learned about that. Outer circle, which is addendum circle. RV means base circle, so we learn about, so these also very important terms, we will see it. Okay, then RR, which is root circle radius. Root circle radius means redundant below circles. Okay, let's see what is the actual base circle. Okay, so there are two types which is used in industry for designing a tooth profile. Okay, the first one is involute tooth profile, involute curved tooth profile, and the second one is cycloid geared tooth profile. So let's see what is the most important profile used in industry. Okay, just Google it once more time. Most used here tooth profile industry. Involute tooth profile. So we will learn about the involute tooth profile only. Okay, so so let's see what is the base circles. So when we have to draw, when we draw one gear with the help of involute curved tooth profile, there is one imaginary circle. Okay, which helps to draw an involute curve, which is known as base circles. Okay, which is, this is RB, base circles. So just understand the things. If you want involute curve, then we need a base circles. Okay, so there are many formulas are here. So with the help of this formula, So with the help of this formula, we will draw a base circles, base RO, RP, and RR things, all the things. Okay, so look at here. So this is our these are our base circles, and with the help of this, so look at here. So involute curved tooth profiles. Okay, suppose this is one gear. Okay, so this is one gear, and if you draw, okay, so if you put one point here, suppose this is one point. Okay, so when we rotate this gear, this point also get rotated. Okay, so suppose this point goes here, then suppose here. Okay, so into this point, we draw one tangent lines like this. Okay, like this. And this tangent has some value. Okay, so how you put the value, we'll learn it later. But if you draw one tangent, and then you can draw one curve at the end point of this tangent. So we get one curve. So that curve is known as involute curve tooth profiles. Okay, involute curve, sorry, involute curve. This is the terminology we use to develop a gear. So that's the things, okay, with the help of this, all the formulas. With the help of this, all the formulas, we will learn the things. Okay, so in the next session, we will see how we can draw a gear with the calculations. Okay, in CATIA, V5, R21, so you use anything. So there you got one formula toolbar. So with the help of this formula toolbar, we will put all the formulas into that and just design one gear. Okay, so today we stop here and we will meet with another fresh session. Thank you. Bye.